Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. About 3 months ago, one of my students have this bridge tool problem. He has this cool-looking sword that he modeled for a game he is working on. And when he tried to bridge it, the result always look wrong somehow. I will try to recreate the problem in this video and solve it so we all can learn something from the experience. There are several things we can learn from this case. First, about normals. Then about the back face cooling, and second about shell modifier. First about normal. In 3D application, every surface has a normal direction. That direction is perpendicular to the surface. So imagine if this world or our Earth is a giant sphere. The normal direction of the surface in which we are standing will be when we look up straight into the sky. Okay? Now the normal always facing one way. For example, I have this plane object in the scene. The normal of this plane surface is actually this way along the z-axis, not this way to minus z-axis. You might be asking, okay, so what's the big deal? Here is the big deal. Here is why knowing the normal direction is important. First, there are many polygon modeling tools inside 3ds Max work based on the normal direction. For example, the bridge tool. Wrong normal direction means wrong result. Second, in many game engine, seeing a surface not from its normal direction will make the surface looks invisible. So if you model something and when exporting it to a game engine and the surfaces look strange, you might want to check the normals of your 3D model. Okay, so now how can we check the normals of our object in 3ds Max? If we look at this plane, for example, it looks the same from top or from the bottom. Well, this is because the back face cooling is not turned on. While the object is selected, go to Object Properties, go to General tab, and turn on this back face cooling on. Okay, now if we look at our plane object, we can see it looks solid from the top, but when we look at it from the bottom, it looks transparent or invisible to be precise. With this back face cooling turned on, we know now that the normal of the plane surface is this way, not this way. Usually, I always turn on the back face cooling. If you want to turn on back face cooling every time an object is created, you can use this option in Customize menu, Preferences, Viewports, and turn on this back face cool on object creation option. Okay, going back to my student's word, when we turn on back face cooling, we can notice right away that the surface of this part is facing the wrong direction. We can select the whole element and flip the normals. Now when I select both of these borders and use the bridge command, they will connect it correctly. Okay, that is nice and all, but we can go even further. We can use shell modifier for this kind of task. And it should be more efficient as less steps needed to achieve the same result. So I will undo this several times, delete this element, and just add shell modifier. We can adjust the value in here as you like, and now we have thickened the sword just like before, but without the extra steps. I actually explained this normal direction and back face cooling in depth in my Udemy course. So check it up if you haven't seen it. I provide the link below in the description. Okay guys, I hope this short video helped you somehow. If you have any problems around CG, such as 3ds Max or Photoshop or Illustrator or any other software that I may know, just send me a message and I will try to answer it in a form of video. Thank you for watching. Wassalamualaikum.